Thank you so much for joining us both tonight. I am joined by my beautiful friend, Jenny. And we're just going to do a relaxing and calming facial for her tonight. So I hope you enjoy. So I'll just pop her hair back. And I'm just going to start with taking some hot towels and very gently wiping over Jenny's face and her neck, just to open the pores a little bit before I place product on them. So I have this oil to foam cleanser, and it is from a company called Rail Beauty. Just add a bit of water to emulsify this. And it is very nice cleanser. As you can see, it foams up beautifully, and I very much enjoy using this cleanser. It doesn't strip the skin, it's very light, and it smells beautiful as well. So I'm just going to gently massage that into Jenny's face. Just using small circular motions around her chin. Moving on to the top of her lip. And then her cheeks and sides of her face. And then up to her forehead as well. Around her eyes. Around her eyes, her nose, and the bottom of her chin as well. As I said, this cleanser is so nice. I've used it personally for the past 6 months. And I'll just take the warm mitts and gently wipe the cleanser away from Jenny's face. So Jenny has beautiful skin, and I would say it is very much normal. It's not dry nor oily. It accepts a lot of products. It's quite happy to have all types of products placed onto her skin. So that's good. Just going to help balance Jenny's skin again. And again, it smells beautiful as well. Start with gliding it over her chin, up to her cheeks, and then over her forehead, making sure to get the nose and the top of the lip. Also just glide it gently over the neck. So I have this peptide booster. And this is quite a reasonably priced one from a pharmacy company called Superdrug in the UK. And it's beautiful. I really enjoy using this peptide serum. It's very light and not too sticky. And it goes on the skin very nicely. So I'm just going to pat that onto her skin. I'm not going to rub it in necessarily. Just being very gentle in my placement of the serum. And I'm just using my fingertips really to just gently push the serum into her skin, just so gently, because this facial is based more on relaxation than like a thorough cleanse. But we are still managing to get these beautiful and beneficial products products into the skin at the same time. So Jenny's skin is already feeling a lot more soft and hydrated, but I'll just grab a little bit more of the peptide serum, just because this stuff is so, so good, and it really does do wonders for the skin. Just pat a little bit more of the peptide serum into her skin. And I like to kind of bit of finger tapping as well, because this can feel really nice and tingly. I like to pay some attention to the third eye area, or the top of the nose, just between the eyebrows. Because this can really feel nice and relaxing, and it can also help you relax a little bit more as well. So I'm going to move on and use a facial oil on Jenny's skin now. And I know I use this one a lot, but it's such a nice oil to use on the face. It's a rosehip oil. And again, I'm just going to very gently massage that into her skin, not adding too much pressure. Just evenly distributing it. And I like to be very gentle with my movements. I like them to be slow and fluid. Just so that the person who I'm giving the treatment to can just really take in everything which is going on, the massage, the aromas. I would hate to feel that my client or friend felt that the treatment had been rushed in any way. I always like to just take my time with my clients and my friends. I don't have a clock in my room. I don't like to kind of clock watch, if you will. I'm just done when I'm done. I'm going to use this aromatherapy ball, and this is one for peace, and I'm just applying it to the temple points and the pulse points, and along her jawline as well. And I'm going to be using these beautiful rose quartz wands. They feel so nice on the skin. They're very cool and very smooth over the skin. So I'm just going to do a gentle massage over her face with the wands. Just being gentle around the eye area. We don't want to apply too much pressure around here because the skin is very thin and sensitive. This is just really going to help push all of the products in, the oil and the serum, and it feels very nice as well. I feel it's nice to incorporate a more cooling sensation within a facial sometimes, especially after you have kind of worked the products into the skin whilst the pores are still open, because this will really help lock all of those beautiful products in and just close the pores down a little bit and just seal the skin really. And this will help with any puffiness or congestion she may be experiencing. And they're really nice tools to just use on the temple area. And on the cheeks as well, as I'm doing now. great for a little bit of lymphatic drainage. Just trying to release any toxins from the skin. Just trying to push them into the right direction of the flow of the lymphatic drainage system. But I'm still just being quite gentle with these ones. I have this eye gel from an amazing brand called Mudmasky. I haven't actually used this product yet, so we'll see what the effects are. But I'm just going to gently pat it all the way around Jenny's eye bone, just making sure not to get too close to the eyes, because obviously we would not like to get product into the eye area, and we don't want any irritation either. So I'm just working from the outline of where I placed the gel and just massaging it into her skin. Again, just using my fingertips very gently around this area of the face, because it is so sensitive. Just gentle circular motions around her eyes. I do think it is important to include these kind of products within our daily routine at home. Eye creams can be very beneficial for usually the area which shows signs of aging the quickest, and that is usually around our eyes. But there is nothing wrong with a few laughter lines, I feel. It's all just part of the journey. So now I have rubbed the eye gel in. I'm going to move on to give Jenny a very gentle and relaxing scalp massage. I'll just take off her headband. And I'm going to start with a gentle trace from her neck over her ears and into her hair. Start to really relax her and make her feel calm and safe. And I'll gently run my fingers through pieces of her hair. Jenny has beautiful hair. It's so nice and soft. I love to do a gentle touch on people before I go into the scalp massage because I just think it enhances the whole feel and sensation of the treatment. And then I'm just going to use my fingertips to gently massage her scalp. And I am being quite firm. Because I do want this to be a stimulating scalp massage for her. I also do like to mix it up a little bit and add soft touch with the massage also. So for the next few minutes, I invite you to just enjoy the relaxing and tingly sounds of this scalp massage. I do like to try and get all areas of the scalp when I give a scalp massage, so I'm very happy to gently move the client's head to the left or the right if required. Because it does feel really nice to have the massage extended to the lower part of the scalp and the top of the neck as well. Just gently move her to the left and repeat the same process. Running my fingers over her neck and her ear, and then going into a gentle massage on this side of the back of her head. We can hold a lot of tension in this area as well. So again, it's nice to just try and work out any tension which we may be holding in this area. hand back on Jenny, just to get her hair out of the way for the remainder. And I'm going to finish the facial with this really nice moisturising spritz, again from Rare Beauty, and it's so nice, it's so nice. And I'm just going to spritz her face, not too close because obviously I don't want it to be pinpointed to an area of her face, I just want it to gently mist over her face. And there you have it. A relaxing, nourishing facial. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. I really do appreciate it. If you have enjoyed this video, then please maybe think about subscribing to my channel. It would be lovely to have you over here. But until next time, please take care of yourself, and I'll see you soon. Bye.